In the beginning was the Word, and the first recorded word was sound. So in the beginning were the words and sound. Then sound from mouth to palm to page, through age to age, and even now, when phone drones march across the face of it all, and pandemic is marked across the face of it all, in the face of it all, still. Words are crowned. Words provoke, cast shadows, expose, propose and impose, make way for tomorrows. Words can stand. They stand for man, for woman, for human, for anyone and everyone who needs a voice. We write and speak to entertain, to educate. Our words can write change in the face of it all. And we will remember those to whose words we still bow. Write them loyal cantons and sing them loud, even in the dead of night, so darkly bright. We saw the light because of them. And words were all we needed then, when then was now. Before we even knew how to read, or write, or sing, or speak. Because first, we knew how to listen.
When you go down. until they're not. Men are kind until they aren't. Flowers bloom until they rot and fall apart. Is anybody listening? I open my mouth, but nothing comes out. Nothing. Nothing gonna wake me now. Flowers. I remember fields of flowers, soft beneath my heels, walking in the sun. I remember someone by my side, turned his face to mine, and then I turned away into the shade. This way, come and find me lying in the bed I made.
Trying their luck. If you stayed home, didn't want to come at all, which is fair enough. I mean, I wasn't sure I wanted to go, but classic FOMO. Now that I'm here though, I'm not sure it's gonna be that fun. The guys that are in there, they are sending us photos and they look pretty boring. That's it. Hey! Yeah, it's us. No, we're still outside. Yeah, in the queue. Yeah, I can't hear you. What? Is it good in there? Is it worth it? What? I can't. Okay, bye. I can't understand a word, honestly. It's like they're talking another language sometimes. I think they're saying they're having a great time. You've got to come in. You'll love it. You won't regret it. But I might regret it. I mean, once you're in, you are in. I'm not sure they let you leave. You don't see anyone coming out, do you? And yes, I know, there's never gonna be a perfect time to go in and it won't be open forever. But still, I'm not ready, I don't think. I'm liking it outside, in the fresh air, full of anticipation, freedom. Even if it is getting cold and late. This is a metaphor, obviously. Shall I or shall I not join the club? The baby club. In the club. Now that is a stupid fucking phrase. I'm standing in the queue. I ain't got a clue, so come give me a hug. No, don't, obviously. I'm fine. I'm just debating, dithering. I'm cool. I'm A-okay. I mean, I have to be, right? I've got a ticket, a choice. Others don't. I'm lucky. I know I am. Doesn't mean I'm not scared, though. I don't know of what. What if it's like a rave you can't escape from? That although euphoric at times, never ever ends. Then maybe I won't realise that once I'm in there. Maybe I'll forget what it's like before, outside, like amnesia. No, not the club in Ibiza. At the end of the night there, you can actually leave the club and go home. Good times. No, actual amnesia. Maybe. I don't know. But, yeah, I'll go in. I'm ready. And I'm at the front of the queue now, so I may as well, right? Sure. I'm ready. I am absolutely ready. Oh, big scary bouncer shouting. Sorry, what? I say, you coming in, love? He says.
Jane was in the bed on my other side, and she pretty much kept herself to herself the first few days, not really saying much, but glaring fluently. Then she'd sort of exploded.
So I've been seeing this guy for about 2 months, right? And I think it's getting serious. Then 3 weeks ago, he gets this job promotion from work. It's a good one. And it comes with a lot of perks. And one of those perks is a lanyard. Bright orange with white writing and a little card with his name on it. He's so proud, bless him. And you know what? He fucking deserves it. He works so hard. But then I notice I'm seeing him without it less and less. Yeah. He started off fine. We'd meet after work for a drink and he'd still be wearing it fine. We've all done it. But then we started meeting at weekends, bank holidays, days off, times when he'd definitely not been at work and he'd still be wearing it. He wore it on date nights, to restaurants and cinemas, out with friends. He wore it to my sister's wedding. He wore it to his own auntie's funeral. You can see it in the photos. And I feel bad for having a problem with it, right? Because this lanyard represents everything he's worked so hard to achieve. It's a symbol, isn't it? It's his authority, his manhood. That is not just a lanyard, it's a manyard. And I've tried to come to terms with it, really I have, but it's just so strange. Pretty soon it became the first thing he put on in the morning and the last thing he'd take off at night. Sometimes I'd think he wasn't wearing it. And then I'd see it. Poking out the back of his collar, a little band of orange. And I'd realise he was wearing it under his shirt. Next to the flesh. And then, just before I came here, we had our final night together. And we were, you know, and he took his top off and there it was. Dangling down like a big orange V-neck without the jumper attached to it. And I went to take it off. And he grabbed my hands in his and he said in a voice laced with passion, "No, leave it on." And I thought, "All right, Jane, come on. Let him have this. It's the last time in a while. Maybe it'll be all right." And he lay me down, and I... So what do you reckon? Should I get one too?
Sad eyes. They've seen things you never quite say, but I hear. Come out of hiding, I'm right here beside you. And I'll stay there as long as you'll let me. Because you matter to me. Simple and plain, and not much to ask from somebody. You matter to me, I promise you do. You matter too, I promise you do. You'll see. You matter to
me. It's addictive
me.
The minute you let yourself think. The things that I say just might matter to someone. All of this time I've been keeping my mind on the running away. And for the first time, I think I'd consider the stay. Because you matter to me. Simple and plain, and not much to ask from somebody. You matter to me. I promise you to you. You matter too. I promise you to.
Here beside you, as long as you're
I promise you
me.
Do.